Welcome to Houston Medical Clerkship. My name is Dr. Faisal Khan. Today we have a very special presentation by our own research fellow, Dr. Muhyiddin. He is with me for the last 1 year and has published several peer-reviewed journal publications heading for neurology residency for the upcoming match. Wish you best of luck, Dr. Muhyiddin. Today the topic is RCVS, which is an extremely challenging diagnosis for the treating physician. So we hope that this presentation will enlighten us. Dr. Muhyiddin.
Thank you, Dr. Khan. So my name is Dr. Muhyiddin and I'm presenting today on reversible cerebral vasoconstriction syndrome, also known as shortly as RCVS. So I'm going to start today's presentation with basically the terminologies that are known to define this symptom. Those include migraine vasospasm or migraine angiitis, thunderclap headache associated vasospasm, postpartum cerebral angiopathy, central nervous system pseudovascularitis. So basically all of these names are known to present RCVS, and these also, the names also include some of the etiologies of this presentation. So this RCVS basically presents a thunderclap headache that has an aura associated with nausea and photosensitivity, and as the name suggests, it's reversible and the pain relieves within a few minutes to a couple of hours. However, this condition is followed by recurrent exacerbations. This condition has many triggers, including vessel-like maneuvers of exertion, cough, sex, and defecation. And 33% of the patients also have systolic hypertension. And then with this condition complicates, it develops focal neurological deficits. In the first week of presentation, the complications include either press or hemorrhages, which can include subarachnoid hemorrhages. And in the second week, the complications can include TIA or cerebral infarcts. And only 21% of the patients also present with seizures. So these are basically some of the etiologies and agents that are associated with this condition. So for example, most pregnant patients also present with RCVS. Some medications are also included with RCVS, including anti-migraine medications, adrenergic agents, and chemotherapeutic agents. Most carcinoid tumor and pheochromocytoma can also present with RCVS. And some conditions, some change in temperature, some change in environment can also present, patients can also experience RCVS symptoms. So this is basically the RCVS score that is used to diagnose this condition. This is the RCVS 1 score. We'll go into RCVS 2 score in the next slide. So RCVS 1 score, there are four conditions that there's only single recurrent thunderclap headache. On MRI, on CTA, or on angiography, we see multifocal segmental cerebral artery vasoconstriction. That is also known as the sausage sign. And then there is no evidence of aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage. And brain imaging findings are of a normal and may show vasogenic edema or flare circle hypertensity dot sign. I'll show you that image in a couple of slides. Right. So moving on to RCVS2 syndrome scores. So this is a newly developed score that was developed in 2019. So basically, we give points, criteria to all the conditions. If there's a single episode or recurrent episode, we give 5 points. If there's carotid artery narrowing shown, that we subtract 2 points. If there's a vasoconstrictive trigger present, that's one of the triggers that I mentioned in slide 2, we give 3 points. If it's female, because female have more tendency to develop this, we give 1 point. In the presence of subarachnoid hemorrhage, we give 1 point. And then adding all the points, this is specificity and sensitivity of all the scores of this RCVS2 performance. So this is the basically differential diagnosis of this condition and the differentiating features of this. So one of the most common is aneurysmal subarachnoid hemorrhage that can also presents with altered consciousness, seizures, and meningismus, which means neck pain. On CT, we will see subarachnoid blood. On lumbar puncture, we will see xanthochromia. And angiography, if the aneurysm ruptures, we will see that on angiography. And then The other one, main one, is cerebral venous sinus thrombosis that presents with focal neurological deficits, autonomic status, and visual signs. On brain CT, dense triangle sign, clot sign, and are the most specific signs, but they have a very low incidence. On lumbar puncture, we'll see elevated opening pressure and higher protein, and angiography will show the thrombus. So this is a flowchart that can be found on Houston Medical College website that's been developed by me and Dr. Khan. And this is shows the radiological signs of RCVS on different imaging, neuroimaging. So this is the standard one that I mentioned, that is the sausage and string signs that's seen on angiography, and that is resolves within 3 months. Then on GRE, we can see intraparenchymal hemorrhages. That was one of the complications that I mentioned before. On flare MRI, we can see subarachnoid hemorrhage that is mostly convectional. And we can also see the flare MRI hypertense dot sign. That means the arteries, cortical arteries, are dilated. We can also see crescent shape hyperintensity. That means there's vasogenic edema present due to rupture of the aneurysms. And then we can also see watershed infarct areas in the on DWI. So as mentioned before in the last slide, these are different kinds of images. This is the hypertense dot sign. And then this is the basically DWI showing infarcts over here. This is the watershed infarcts over here. And then basically, we can see convectional subarachnoid hemorrhage over here. And these are basically the combination of lesions we can find on different neuroimaging for our CVS. This is the pathogenesis. The pathogenesis is not confirmed, basically. So we are not sure yet whether the headaches happens first or whether the cerebral vessel constriction happens first. But the we can basically narrow down the roots, the nerve roots, basically trigeminal, sensory, and C2 dorsal roots supply both the headache and the cerebral vessels. And these are the complications that I mentioned. Hemorrhages happen in the first week, and ischemic stroke can happen in the second week, and can present in focal neurological deficits. Okay, so management. So RCVS has no basically management. So we just do symptomatic therapy, that is controlling the blood pressure, as I've mentioned before, 33% of the patients have systolic hypertension. And so for the pain, we use NSAIDs, and we avoid any triggers that was mentioned before. For vasoconstriction, the pharmacological treatment includes dantrolene and serotonin antagonist. While the, if the patient still has headaches and symptoms despite all this pharmaceutical treatment, we then can do intra-arterial vasodilation by either administration of calcium blockers and PDE inhibitors, or the last option is balloon angioplasty. So, as the name suggests, it's reversible, and the symptoms usually resolve within days to weeks, and complications can only occur in 15 to 20% of the patients. And with severe complications, only happen in 5% of the cases. These severe complications include massive stroke, brain edema, morbidity, and death. And recurrence occurs in approximately 5 to 6% of the cases. All right, thank you.